Biafra in London, Biafra in Germany, Biafra everywhere, Biafra in Russia, Biafra in Asia, everybody likes it. They tried to kill us many years ago, killing the people of Biafra. Nobody can stop Biafra, I say it. Nobody can stop Biafra. Nobody can stop Biafra, because Biafra is strong. You can judge the leader. Biafra. Every time I play this, a Babylon I wish me every day. Every time I sing this, a Babylon I wish me every day. They tried to kill us many years ago, killing the people of Biafra, destroying the people of Biafra. Nobody can stop Biafra. Nobody can stop Biafra. Nobody can stop Biafra, because Biafra is strong. Nobody can stop Biafra. Nobody can stop Biafra. Nobody can stop Biafra, because Biafra is strong. Biafra in bedroom, Biafra in bathroom, Biafra everywhere. Biafra in jail, Biafra in church, everybody likes it. They tried to kill us many years ago, killing the people of Biafra, destroying the people of Biafra. Nobody can stop Biafra. Nobody can stop Biafra. Nobody can stop Biafra, because Biafra is strong. I told you, nobody can stop Biafra. Nobody can stop Biafra. Nobody can stop Biafra, because Biafra is strong. Nobody can stop Biafra. Nobody can stop Biafra, Obama. Nobody can stop Biafra, because Biafra is strong. Britain. Nobody can stop Biafra. Nobody can stop Biafra. Nobody can stop Biafra, because Biafra is strong. Nobody can stop Biafra. Nobody can stop Biafra. Nobody can stop Biafra, because Biafra is strong.
Yes, fellow Biafras, lovers of freedom, men and women of goodwill, consciousness, people wherever you are all over the world, I say good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and to some of you, good night, depending on your time zone. Of course, this is Radio Biafra Extra. Radio Biafra Extra is streaming live to Radio Biafra London. Radio Biafra near the indigenous people Biafra. His name is Mazi Uchi Uka from Efo. He is from Abatete. Abatete is in Anambra State. And Anambra State is Biafra land. Mazi Uchi Uka from Efo is the man who have assured us that he will not allow the heart of this project to prosecuted to Nigeria. We have one or two things to do with Nigeria and in Nigeria. And we can assure you that corruption, Nigeria is corruption in personification. And when he gave those words, one day you will understand his mindset. And of course, Mazu Chuka, from a first time in a deputized capacity on behalf of our leader, Mazu Nnamdi Okanu, he is the king of the family. Is here. Umuahia, Abia State is pure land. For almost years, our honors refused to speak of this. As being displayed by the Nigerian terrorist state by the terrorist in this is what we know. But we will answer to make them eliminate. That is the problem. And so for 60 years or more, nobody have been able to stand up against the terrorist camp in Grand Africa, known as Nigeria. And the country is that is to put fire in the world. Nigeria is a hellfire already. Why would any normal human being want to sustain Nigeria? We want to overthrow the government of Nigeria. We just want to divide Nigeria. We want to stop Nigeria because Nigeria is worse than Kudu virus. Nigeria is worse than Ebola, bird flu, and all of them put together. And now, if you are listening to me, I want you to beam your satellite on Nigeria. You see, they are not afraid of coronavirus because Nigeria is worse than coronavirus. And so why will anybody be afraid of coronavirus when they have Nigerian keys in their hand? And now, maybe you begin to understand why we are here. I am George Bay. I come from Abo. Abo is in Delta State, and Delta State is Biafra land. Of course, as always, I will not proceed until I acknowledge the Creator. I call him Chukwuka Kabiama. Some call him Tamono. Others call him Abasembo. Whatever it is you call the Creator. The truth remains that we worship one, the one who made the heavens and the earth. And this morning, I humble myself and acknowledge him. Worship the Lord, the great I am. Worship the Lord, the great I am. Oh, he's eternal. The step one we follow. The Lord God we worship. He's the great I am that I am. Yes, we worship. We worship the Lord, the great I am. Lord, we worship you. We worship the Lord, the great I am. Enter now, the only God and steadfast, the God that is the only one we worship. Sena the maro. You see. Without wasting much of our time, we will go to our study this morning. And Biafrans across the globe, those of you on Facebook, I want you to monitor Facebook. If you notice my voice, they have started distorting my voice, the audio, let me know. Because, you know, we can only get better. Pekin will say, Mama no go sleep, he no go sleep. The more they are practicing, studying how to distract us, so the world will not know what they are doing to us. We are also battling to see how we can still be functioning. We is not here free. We didn't hack their system. We they are the one even violating their own privacy or policy. And so those of you on Facebook, you notice them saying, just emboss me. If you have my emboss, text me, let's know. Can we say Mama no go sleep? Ain't no go sleep. We will help Facebook to make sure they deter the whole of their audio. They are paying for the services. Not free. The whole world post anything on Facebook. But here in IPO, because of the front issue, since the owner of Facebook came to Nigeria, Facebook has not been the same again. Facebook have not been the same again. But then we must continue. Bible says many are the affliction of the righteous. And in my own words, I will tell you, many are the affliction of the front. But you could kick up your man will see through in all of them. Because be rest assured, we are not backing down. Having said that, we go to our topic this morning. It's simply titled, have you ever wondered what their target is when they carry out the following activities? I want us to look at just different activities that is being carried out by Nigerians almost on daily basis. And even with you with such issues or agenda, have you ever wondered why? Have you ever wondered? As a child, I used to hear about the seven wonders of the ancient world. They can tell you about the statues of Zeus and Olympias. They can tell you about the hanging garden of Eden. They can tell you about so many things. It's wonder. But you, have you ever wondered when Nigeria makes certain claim? Baby, you just look at them that way. Now let me tell you. The reason why our ancestors tell the children stories is to enable them articulate or activate the side of that enables them to reason as well. Our ancestors have a way of telling story. They call it tales by moonlight. Every night or every evening before bed, they will gather their children and they will tell them a story. And these stories are conveyed to pass a message. And sometimes they will what touches did. How touches were smart to outsmart the rest of the animal. We all know or believe that touches is the wisest animal in the animal kingdom. We all know or believe that lion is the wisest, strongest animal in the animal kingdom. And each time it is these stories. Not our they tell us help. I can assure you that more than 70% touches the deed. Europeans who have the best is themselves, the beauty and the beast, and so on and so forth. But what research has proven, introduction of video game is another way to make your children think faster. And if you go to studies, you will find out that children who play video game on a tender age are smarter than children who don't have access to it. And so they have the way of making their children think faster. I will not digress further. But what I'm trying to say in non-share is that the reason or one of the reasons we come on Radio Biafra and keep telling you stories about what is happening to us as a people, about what is happening in Nigeria, about what is going to happen somewhere around the world, is to help you at your thinking faculty. We have been thinking all this while. And first, I'm thinking. I was going to use online. People having the religion, just tell them that if you don't read with the Jew Igbo now, it's not an Igbo man, because they have come again. The question is, have you want somebody Igbo now who is not an Igbo man, but a Igbo man with his name before presidency? But if you think, he will think he mean well for us. And then there are some youth, that is why Buhari and Nigeria call them lazy youth from Niger Delta, who gather themselves and video themselves and say, we want our rights. Our right is our stipends. Give us our 30,000 years or 8 years now. You have not given us our chop money. Come and give us our chop money. We will command the river to stop. We will command the earth to stop blowing. We will command thunder to come down. But you are idiot. This is one thing you don't like. You are idiot. You are not reasoning. In a time like this, if Biafran is still coming out to cry for stipends, for amnesty, are you an idiot? But you don't understand. To you, you tell all about the chop money. In all ye producing communities in Biafra land, we are breeding a bountiful harvest of watermelon and cucumber. But in the desert, somewhere in Borno State, Katsina State, Kano State, they are celebrating the commissioning of another highway, an international airport, up to the extent that they went inside the Sambi, desert, and build seaport. The Nigerian build seaport inside desert. Unamumu never do, according to Charlie Boy. Unamumu never do. But the reason we come here is to help you to begin to reason. Honestly. Because if you do not understand the game they are playing with you, there is no way you will resist them. And only those who are calculative, only those who are meticulous, only those who are systematically observing the zoo called Nigeria will understand the truth. You will deny us. You will resist us. You will antagonize us. You will not agree with us. You will not our pattern. But very soon you will become part of us. And it is now to Yedepo now acknowledge that Nigeria is a zoo, animal kingdom. But all of you are deceiving yourself. But don't worry. The music, the volume is increasing on a daily basis. And so I call upon you, Biafra. When I come, I tell you, you are an idiot. If you are wise, go and find out if you are one. When we on radio, Biafra, we tell you, you don't have sense. What you are supposed to do is to go and find out if it's true. When two brothers are playing, there is an adage in my place. They say, when he ya gwa no no alishi, no rapa yi. It's only your brother that that is smelling, that it will not look like an insult. We still see Nigerian like our extended brother. We want them to respect themselves and remain on their own. So if you are Nigerian, we tell you are idiot. Go and check if you are an idiot. Because when your brother tell you and say, uncle, auntie, sister, brother, your mouth is smelling. You are supposed to check if your mouth is truly smelling. Not to begin to yap, because you pollute the air the more. The point is that you people will join us very soon. Our leader was saying they could, they are planning to attack. And the propaganda, did two white one of the terrorists not repeat what our leader said? This is how all of you will say no. But all of you will follow it later. And a day will come, we will be videoing all of you. And you will admit that indeed you are an idiot. Because for you to be here and you can't see what is happening, may the Lord be with you. What am I trying to say in non-share? On Radio Biafra, we keep keeping you and highlighting on everything that is happening, hoping that your medulla oblongata will be activated and you will be able to see the truth. Because the Bible says, and you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. I know the feeling anyway, but you will know the truth. You are there fighting for chop money. The Boko Haram who are ravaging your community are going to be sent to America. Some will be sent to London. They will be sent across the globe to go and learn how to come and kill you. And they are coming back. And one thing is that people do not know we have passed that stage. Those my brothers who are fighting for chop money, who are yapping, go and check the number of Fulani Navy that are in your question. No, go and check. You will understand why Asare has kept quiet. You will understand why many people have not been saying anything. But you don't know what is happening. Join the good people of Biafra land and join IPOB. Anybody trying to divide IPOB is wasting their time. Come and join Biafra Adiamama. Go and IPOB and join. And so this morning I want us to consider so many things and activate our brain. Nigerians cannot fool us any longer, and we cannot afford to allow them to fool us. I see things. We have seen things. There are a lot of people, for instance, on social media, when they are doing what they are doing, you think they are with IPOB. They are not. They are not. Because if you want to be famous now, touch IPOB. You want to become relevant, insult IPOB. People will call you and pay you money. That is why we welcome all of you. Of the world are compromised already just because of our issue. Nigeria was going everywhere distributing money. If country, government of any country fighting against us, we have collected their own share. Like I said, those who are on Facebook told you, you notice anything, let me know. But of course, we must continue. A lot of things have happened, but most of us do not even consider the mindset behind those actions. Because you are always on it, you just walk away when you see time people. Number one, I want you to consider this reason about is the number one there. When they keep making you promises that they do not intend to fulfill. For instance, when you hear them talk about Igbo presidency, I have been hearing this since I was born. I always Igbo presidency, Igbo presidency, Igbo presidency. It looks like they are doing us favor. And this is how they deceive the Biafrans on the upland. And then they come to Biafrans on the coastal region. You begin to hear things like, Ogoni clean up, Ogoni clean up, Ogoni clean up, Ogoni clean up. And then they move back to the Biafrans on the upland. You begin to hear, Second Niger Bridge, Second Niger Bridge, Second Niger Bridge. And then all of a sudden they come back to the coastal region. You begin to hear amnesty, amnesty, amnesty. What have you ever wondered what they have in mind when they are doing that thing? What do you think they were doing? If they built Second Niger Bridge, how many years did they canvass to build Third Mainland Bridge? The resources that was used to build Third Mainland Bridge in Yoruba land, if you divide it into two, one part would have rounded up Second Niger Bridge. But the only thing they are doing there when they tell you Ogoni clean up, the only thing they are doing there when they tell you Igbo presidency, when the only thing they do there when they tell you Second Niger Bridge is just to buy the time and keep you as a dummy that they think you are. And most of you buy it. The president of Muhammadu, late Muhammadu Buhari, in 2015, their number one project was to deceive the Biafrans. Osibanjo ran to Ogoni and he said he's here to commission or flag off of Ogoni cleanup. I know many Ogoni people. They came out on social media. He said, welcome development. We know Buhari is a good man. Buhari will do something. I hope they have cleaned it up. Another idiot come to your land and say you want to do Ogoni cleanup. Are you this daft? You don't know they are using you to buy time. It's another one now. They are going to pay one of your brother. Only one. That is why you have people compete aside. If you are a Ogoni man, Ogoni woman, God, go and look at the people that endorse the killing of your brother, Kensar Wiwa. You will see how Ogoni people. And watch all of them. You will see they are your political group. Go and ask that Magnus Abe. He knows what I'm doing. In fact, Magnus Abe is one of the signatory people that signed that they should kiss Kensar Wiwa. Today, some of you are idiots. It's your political guru. But do you have sense? They will still pay another person. And that person will be expense of all of you. This is how they keep us down. And so anytime you hear them repeating the same prayer, promises, their only agenda is to buy time. Have you ever wondered? Have you ever wondered? When they promise you restructure and renovation, is their intention? One of the greatest lies, the lie to our parents, was after the war. They say it is reconstruction, rehabilitation, and reintegration. The three arrows. But tomorrow, they are still making the same promises. They fooled our parents. They told them it's no victory, no conquest. Till today, our parents are still waiting for reconstruction. We are still waiting for the rehabilitation. We are still waiting to be reintegrated inside this zoo. And today they say it's IPOB. If IPOB have waited over 40-something years before we reacted. And there was a time they told you that they are going to repair, renovate Enugu. Everybody was happy. Nayamudu, all of you went to Abuja with Iwanya, collected some money. Now you can't talk about Enugu Airport. The only functioning airport in the upland region of Biafra land. Iwanyangun, Nayangudu, and the rest went to see Jubri. In Aso Rock, they collected money. They issue press communique. It's still on the social media. This is where God will punish all these people. If you people repent, your sin will catch up with you very soon. And they told us that before the eve of the past Christmas, the Enugu Airport is. Go there now, those of you in Enugu. How market? A lot of people were saying, yes, it's a welcome development. The airport needs to be renovated. They are not renovating anything. Port Harcourt Airport is the only functioning one. They can call it international airport. But we all know that you cannot leave from Port Harcourt to anywhere in the world. You have to go to Lagos for searching. Yoruba must search you, or Hausa must search you. Go out. So whenever you hear them about renovation and restructure, just find out what are they trying to do. They have come to deceive you again. They deceive you, they shut down the airport. They deceive you, we don't have seaport. They deceive you, they remove all your people from the political office. They are deceiving you now. Now the reigning one is restructure. Over 10 million Biafrans were slaughtered because Ojukwu asked for restructure. And then, why don't you begin to wonder? Why are they talking about restructure now? I thought Nigeria is unrestructurable. In territorial integrity of Nigeria cannot be restructured according to British government. But they fool you. Have you ever wondered when they promise you, whenever their plans are to prescribe IPO, but if you prescribe the terrorist group, have you ever wondered why Nigeria were very fast to see the prescribed IPOB? But yet they fail to prescribe Boko Haram, they fail to prescribe Fulani herdsmen, they fail to prescribe Miati Allah, they fail to prescribe Arewa Area Boys, they fail to prescribe Lamido Sanusi Lamido. Most of you don't know that man is a terrorist. But will our people ever learn? Of course, it's good you make the information. But nobody should be deceived by what they are doing with Lamido Sanusi. They want to win your sympathy. Many people are saying, he was the one who talked about the poor. All of them are the same thing. If the Fulani will allow the Hausa youth to become enlightened, then their reign will end. So Lamido Sanusi want to remain there. And he knows that it's impossible. Their system of government is oligarchy. Government of Frank Adede. And so anybody who is a Fulani benefiting from Nigeria today, they are telling you, you have to. This is exactly what they want. They are deceiving. So the ordinary Hausa idiot will think Sanusi is talking for them. No. The feudalism system of Fulani, the conquering government of Janjaweed idiot, it is government of Frank Adede. But you people cannot reason. A lot of you are going to dig out the good thing that man did. That man is a terrorist. He's supposed to be prescribed. Do you think that governor, Gwangwado or Gwangbu, that idiot criminal, the one that carried a bribe of billions of dollars, that DSS cannot go investigate? Do you think that man don't know what he's doing? I tell you, if Lamido Sanusi, who has more than 12 names, you people don't know he has more than 12 names. The name he answer as a governor of Central Bank, it's not the same name he answer as Emir. He has so many names, but if it's George Onyebunam that is changing his name, they would have called me terrorist. But he's a terrorist. When I come, I say Lamido Sanusi is a terrorist. People say he's just saying it. I'm not just saying it. His action shows he's a terrorist. And so when they see you, don't let them deceive you. the same people. They are using the same motto, only that they normally or regularly change. They came out in a hurry. Oh, we prescribe IPOB. IPOB is a terrorist group. Of course, we say the truth, irrespective of whose source is God. We have not killed anybody. They are testament to that. You be a terrorist by saying the truth. I look at American citizens. Some of them do say unpleasant thing about Donald Trump. I've not heard Donald Trump giving them any attack as a president. I have seen America make making caricature of Donald Trump. But I see the kind of things they do. Or upload one of those videos. Donald Trump don't even talk to them. Because he understands that those things are acceptable in a normal society. But some people are saying, how can you curse our honorable? How can you insult? Do you have honorable in Nigeria? All you have is gang of idiots. Lunatic and British government controlled mind individuals. No honorable in Nigeria. Have you ever wondered if you on Facebook? That is Nigerian people. They want to follow desert. Then cross the Mediterranean Sea. Many of them, if those police or whoever they are did not stop them, return. Then they go to TB Joshua and say, praise the Lord, we wanted to die in the desert. But TB Joshua know their problem. But they keep coming to deceive you that, hey, the synagogue and other churches are helping. This is why we can never stop. Nigeria is the cause of it. Look at this small car. Look at how many people coming out. I'm sure they are to 300 in one small car. Small car. And all these same people now, most of them, tell them to join IPOB. They will prefer to go and die in the Mediterranean Sea or in the desert. Why? Because they don't know the truth. That is why we do here. We must continue. And so they don't want to prescribe all these people, but they are prescribing you. Have you ever wondered why the people in our region have been taken for granted, including our politician, as well as the Nigerian state? Have you ever wondered why the people in our region have been taken for granted? In Biafra land, don't you see they have taken us for granted? When they have money to share, they will say, we will give Bayelsa, we will give Niger Delta. We will not give Delta Niger, because you have Niger Delta and Delta Niger. Upland of Biafra land is Niger Delta. Delta Niger, because they have River Niger in the Ara. Then coastal region, because they don't have River Niger, they are Niger Delta. Have you ever wondered why they take us for granted? We are the one that go to school. We are the one that will not be employed. I challenge you, those of you who want us to come here and begin to do, gentlemen, I challenge you where you work. Look at your boss now as a Biafran. As a Biafran from Idoma, as a Biafran in Edo State, Biafran in Delta, Biafran in Bayelsa, Biafran anywhere, Imo, Enugu, as you are listening to me now, anywhere you are in Nigeria, or you are working for Nigeria anywhere in the world, I want you to look at your boss and tell me of the truth that we are lying, that your boss is more qualified than you. Does these things not give you concern? That come out with first-class upper in your own areas of endeavor, in your own field of academic excellence, you come out with first class. You must be under Yoruba man in Nigeria. Our learning must be as your boss. Have you ever wondered? The company I manage to work with, I work as a contract staff. There is no promise they didn't make to me, but I know what they want. I said no, because I have something they want. And lo and behold, do you know what they want me to do? They want me to meet their people. Let me give you an instance of that company. It's known as Adultrade Company. It was formerly owned by Poland. When I worked for them, it was Anambra man that was the manager. He was later removed because the Poland man who managed Adultrade was as corrupt as the devil. And when the man was removed, they brought in, the company was sued, and they brought in Fulani. Fulani of Nigeria bought the company. What they did was to sack all the Biafrans working in that company. It's called that treat. They have branches everywhere in Nigeria. If you are listening to me, you know the company. Now go there. Every youth walking there are Fulani. And what they did was that they want to use us to train them. I called my colleague. I said, if we train these people, they will remove all of us. If we train these people, they will remove all of us. And they are still doing it today. You are training our Fulani to take over your life. Not because they are going to be better than you, but they are going to use you to replace them. And the same way they did. Some of my colleagues were properly paid. They were compensated. They start teaching this Fulani. But I control an area that they know nothing about. I refuse to give her the formula. I shifted aside. It was not easy for me to survive, but I stood my ground. Of course, they can't do without me at that time. Even till tomorrow that I don't work with them, because they are the one that told DSS how to arrest me. They are the one. It was the company DSS, and they told them, how do we get this man work here? Because they noticed my transaction with them. And that was how they invited me to come to take a look at a job for them. But I'm not holding it against them anyway. But I'm telling you how they function. Those people enjoy for a while. And the moment there are Fulani and Awosa who can do this job, they sack all of them. Until DSS arrested me, I was still working with them as a contract staff. I choose who work with me. How to work with me. How to say, if not, take your business. Not until we begin to have those stands. They will always use our brain. They will bring you, use you to blackmail your people, chase out all of your people. They will keep only you there. You will enjoy temporarily, but you will be dumped at the end of the day. That is what is known as use and dump. That is what our leader mean, go and serve the zoo and come back in shame. Have you ever wondered why they take us for granted? Have you ever wondered why they keep showing up hatred tools against people in the South and the Southeast? Protecting or pretending to show us love. Have you ever wondered? They openly show us hatred. If you want to know what I mean, you are in a vehicle. The moment they know, Isiboma, you say Nyamere, Parabu Dambanza, Parabu, Parabu, the civilian. Have you ever wondered why they show us this hatred in the Nigerian state? Have you ever heard that? The case of Chima in Port Harcourt, they are killing it gradually. The Yoruba man took a class alongside other Yoruba, Hausa, Fulani, and some of our misguided brothers. They used cutlass and cut Chima. Butcher Chima League because they saw 150,000. And Chima is dead. Can they do that? Have you heard the history of a Yoruba man tortured by Nigerian police to death? Not to talk for Hausa, Fulani. But it is Biafra. And sometimes I ever wondered why they show this much hatred. Have you ever wondered about them removing Lamido, Sanusi Lamido? You should go back. What are they trying to achieve? What did Lamido do? So you should be wondering, what are they trying to achieve? Not just rejoicing. Of course, let this action pour in more revelation into the system. But don't make any mistake about it. Obasanjo was in prison. From prison, he became president. They know what they are doing. All of them know what they are doing. Buhari was in prison. He's a president. They will tell you the story of Joseph. From prison, he became a prime minister in Egypt. Don't let anybody deceive you. Oh, he had been banished to Adamawa. From Adamawa, he will be banished to from Mambaraba, and then finally you will hear he's in Ikuje prison. The way you see the local Jews of Kalu, they say, hey, say Lami do not include. And then the next thing you will hear, Mbaka will prophesy that God have said that somebody will from prison and become the president of Nigeria. And all of you have allowed religion to destroy your brain. You are going to be happy, as you are happy that Uzodema was a God-given king. All of you will see it. The same Mbaka made the same prophecy about good luck, calling him bad luck and telling you that Buhari and his children are virtuous of mother and father and Pekin. Have you people wondered? Have you ever wondered why most of the Biafran youth are locked up in Nigerian prison or being killed indiscriminately? Have you ever wondered? Have you ever wondered? I want you to take the liberty of visiting prison. You may not know how to visit prison or police cell. Dress up as a pastor. Carry your Bible. Go to the police station. Tell them you want to pray for people. Of course, they will tell you to bribe them. They don't say bribe also. They will say you will buy tissue paper. You will buy soup. Of course, they are not using tissue paper. They say, okay, where can I get it? They say, bring the money. We can buy it for you. And then go there. Try finding out the name of all the people you will see. I can assure you, number one, you will not see Awosa Fulani inside any police station in Nigeria. If you see them there, they are keeping them there temporarily for protection. Maybe their driver, they have used their trailer to kill one community. So they just keep them till army will come and take them to a safe location. If you see Yoruba there, you know that his people has not come. Because every DPO of police station in Biafra land, all of them are Yoruba. And sometimes people say, don't say this. But why won't you say it because of any idiot? Have you ever wondered? Nigerian police, some of our brother will even lead them. They will come to market, pack everybody. Pack their load, throw them there. Some of them may not return. Have you ever wondered? It's because nobody is standing up to speak for us. Do you ever wonder if he's going? But I can tell you it will never end until we fight back. And finally, have you ever wondered why IPOB said Biafra or death? We will come out, we tell you it is Biafra or death. Have you ever wondered why we said so? You think we really want to, but yet we are ready to die if that is what it takes. But have you ever wondered why? Because if you fight for Biafra and die in the process, better. But be rest assured, if you fail to fight for the restoration of Biafra, they are going to kill you. And so we say that to them to make them understand our readiness, no matter what, to make sure Biafra is restored. My brother, think very well. Listen very well. There is reason behind every action. So also there is reason behind every activity. Every action of Nigeria, there is a reason. Whenever a Nigerian does anything, there is a reason. But I can assure you, every action we take, there is a reason. Activate your reasoning capacity. Begin to study Nigeria and understand how they function as a Biafra. Look for IPOB closer to you and join. If you do not locate one, send us your name, your phone number, and your location on our WhatsApp line. We will connect you to the nearest IPOB. Of course, every coordinator must get ready. Make sure you are preparing the capacity, the structure to bear the burden of the capacity that is coming already. And of course, following through the structure of IPOB. We must go home. We will last miracle. It is called crossing the Red Sea. You will cross with us. Are you going to cross ahead of us? How do we follow later on? It's all your choice. I'll be back in a minute.
From Biafra, I come from the land of the rising.
sir, at this moment, our lines are open. Our WhatsApp line is 070-815-45642. Our WhatsApp line, once again, is 070-815-456. And our direct line is 081-221-52971. Our direct line is 081-221-52971. The special number for the female is 081-288-58614. And of course, like I said, I want to appreciate those of you on Facebook who were able to give me the feedback. And believe me, we can only get better. All are on the line, can you hear me? At least the world knows that Facebook is working hard. But do we want to conquer Facebook? No. What is collected? Money, blood money, our money, stolen from us to undermine our effort. But believe me, we will always conquer them. Are you there, caller on the line? Good morning from here, monitoring spirit.
Dear friends all over the world, may the peace of the Most High people be with every one of us. And we must continue to pray for our deputy, because he is the only one who made it possible for us to get close to the Red Sea. Because he is the Red Sea. Nobody can stop Biafra. And we are Biafra. Are we flying? Are we Yoruba? Are we America? We are Biafra for us. As I said, he wants to go home. And they are just thinking that these people will not know what is going to happen. If you go to Nigeria, anybody that says that it's in Nigeria is already a dead woman. You need to force us into that our ancestors that they people to do. We are reincarnated of people. We have come back to take and not what them. Whatever you like to do, that tonight, that's what I call it. All I have is the direction of the death. That power that you are hoping that we have to make you proud, make you come. Your power is a good power. No other God.
No one question of Fulani will stay in Biafra. Mazot, I'm there, Mazi. Ototo, ma Mazi.
Good morning from here. Go ahead, please.
Ma.
Go ahead. Of course, that is Zoo Epileptic Network, but we must continue. Biafrans across the globe must begin to wonder why. Call on WhatsApp. Go ahead, please.
Mazu Otopoma.
Go ahead, please.
My name is Mazi Okemiri Eberechukwu Okike Abiama. By the special grace of Chukwu Okike Abiama, I am calling from Enyimba City. Enyimba City in Kenonima Aba. Mazu Otopoma. Mazi, I'm very happy on the topic today, because why I'm very happy is you have digressed everything very well. For those of us who have a deaf ear, let us understand that the drum of war is being beaten in this country called Zugeria. Mazi, by special grace of God, I want to let you know that the young men in this Enyimba City has woke up, and we are going to let them know that very soon none of them will be asleep, because we have decided to make the best night. They are making us asleep. The person said that we are highly behind you. We are highly behind IPOB. And whoever that said that we know, will pay by his blood. And I repeat again, you will be able to have rice. You will be able to have sawana. Go on, we are right behind you, but very soon they will hear from us, because we are the rescue team of Israel. We are the Judah tribe, and Judah has awake. And when was Judah awake? The whole tribe of Israel is awake. Long live the lions, long live Mazi Nande Kalu, long live Mazi Chemefo, long live Mazi Onyibe. We will keep on keeping up.
Thank you.
No surrender.
Thank you.
Farewell and God bless. Yahweh bless everybody. Asawana o, wana.
Thank you very much. The truth cannot be overemphasized. We want to go home, and home we shall go. No matter what they do, we have always stood them. We can only get better. We are Biafrans, and we can only get better. Are you there, caller on the line? Good morning from me, please.
My name is Yekuma
Sanda.
I come up back. I'm calling from Ongbo. Our radio is not on at Ongbo right now. Can you hear me?
Yes, go ahead, please.
Okay, I'm greeting for what you're doing for us as a girlfriend, because nobody's doing like you. Thank you.
But you are not paying attention, but we must continue. Call on the WhatsApp. Call on WhatsApp.
Yeah, good morning, Mr. George Oyibe.
Good morning from here.
Good morning, Mr. George Oyibe.
Good morning. Go ahead, please.
This is Sunday Bonia Alami from Kogia State. Yeah, I want to thank you this morning for your breakfast. Sir, we are very grateful for you, though for some days our radio was shut down by the Zoo network, but thank God that last night everything went well. Sir, as a reporter, I just want to pass across to you, though that I have said I've sent a message to this our WhatsApp line. Some people whom I have given the number, you have always called the WhatsApp number, they told me that they have sent message, some say twice, some say three times, they have not gotten respond regards to joining the struggle. So I said, let me say the number, the message to you, so that I will know the message to tell them, because there are so many people on the area where I'm working that are eager to join the struggle. But I give them the numbers. They said I have seen the message 2 or 3 times. They have not received any response.
Thank you. Thank you very much for bringing up that company. And I will still use the to talk to Biafrans across the globe. If you have sent your data and I have not responded to you, or nobody have contacted you, please make sure 1 or 2 times every week, continue receiving, they attend to you. Because I can assure you, I know thousands of people that want to join IPOB across the globe. And believe me, it's not easy. But we are doing the needful. So don't stop until the coordinator contact you. Tell them, I love people. Some people receive them every morning. They will resend it. Continue until they attend to you. Be rest assured, the coordinators are doing the best to do the follow-up. So thank you very much, my brother. You pass the message to them.
Thank you, sir. God bless you, sir.
We must continue. Thank you very much. And of course, like I said, the enemy of Biafra, they are teaching us. They are teaching us. Facebook and everything. But you can see that they will fail in the end. We can only get better. Are you there, caller on the line?
Hello, good morning.
Yes, good morning, my brother. Go ahead, please.
Mazi George Oni, Ben Chukwe Kekabiama, bless you. Ben Chukwe Kekabiama, bless all the IPOB. Ben Chukwe Kekabiama, bless our spin leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. Mazi George Oni, but this is Duncan from here in Aba.
Of course, it is Zoo Epileptic. Call on WhatsApp. Are you there?
Hello.
Call on WhatsApp.
Good morning.
Good morning from here. Your name and where are you calling from?
Yeah, my name is Azemin from Imovum. Nazi, I want to thank you for the good work you are doing for their friends. I want to thank our leader, Mohamed Ikizi. I want to thank Chukwukabiama, who has given us our Hamadike, so that he will liberate us from the shackles of the evil Fulani hegemony. So that have been clamoring for war every time, war. Let me assure them that this war that they are mongering about, nobody has the monopoly of violence. And let me assure them that they don't bleed water. All they bleed blood. Let me assure Ango Abdullah all these Fulanites, because they have turned their terrorism to bandits. That was the new name they have given to themselves. Turned their terrorism to bandits. This war that they are clamoring all the time, this war is going to consume them. And we, the Biafrans, we want to assure them that the Biafrans of 1967 is not the Biafrans of 2020. We are going to show them that what they did to us in 1967, the memory still lives in us. And let me advise Obasanjo, Buhari, the dead Buhari in his grave, T.Y. Danjuma, and co, that we Biafrans, we know the genocide they committed against us. We are not asking them to come and tell us the truth, but we are asking them. We requested from them is to come openly and apologize to us. Because Harold Wilson, the arch genocider, he came openly and apologized to Biafrans and Africans, but to Obasanjo, T.Y. Danjuma, Babangida, and so on and so forth, all of them, they swallowed it and try and want to go to their grave with their genocidal act. If they did not come openly, including Gowan, if they did not come openly and apologize to we, Biafrans, the people, the children and mothers, they murdered, we continue to hurt them even in their own grave, and he is going to lead them to hellfire. Thank you, Master, for giving me this opportunity. This is all the world I want to say. Continue to bless you all.
Thank you very much. Our topic this morning is simple. Have you ever wondered why they do what they do? You just don't need to end up wondering. You need to find out. If Facebook doing what they are doing, you begin to wonder, why is Facebook doing like this? They don't want the world to know what is happening. They don't want the world to know what is going on. They have been doing this before now. They shut the mouth of Biafrans. They call it media blockage. Today they cannot, so they fight us. Facebook, please keep off. We are here. We are here. Why are they trying to go to the voice of freedom? Have you ever wondered? Don't let Nigerian deceive you. Biafrans begin to think it was your freedom. Are you there? Call on WhatsApp. Call on
WhatsApp. Yes,
Master George. Good morning from here. Go ahead, please.
Yeah, good. Yeah. I'm calling from India. I'm Udena. I'm talking. Master George Onyibe, I really, really happy for your teaching today, because your teaching is always giving us more hope and more knowledge for where we are heading to. And we know that where we are heading to is so close. And that's why sometimes I see some Biafran missing blood from Fulani are talking trash over here, because maybe the person are working in behalf of a zoo government over here. They are trying to say anything against Biafrans or talk any trash against Biafran that we are doing, or mocking the people of Biafra. Sometimes I lie for them, because I know where we are heading to is very close, and then there may be the we may mock them as they try to do today. And the mock we can mock them time comes is forever and ever mock. And that's why anytime I came, you be online, I try to listen, because I know I will learn one important thing in my life. I will grow more level in my life, because to listen to Radio Biafra is about knowledge. It's about to white your medulla oblongata to do more things. That's why I'm always encouraging people, all IPOP, all Biafrans, to listen to Radio Biafra, that things positive to come out. I thank you so much for leading Biafran forward, and I pray that God Almighty will keep you and give you more strength. And I thank you to still, because where we're heading to, we are almost where we are heading to. Nobody, no Fulani man, no zoo government should discourage you. Let us continue until we got what we need. All hail Biafra.
Hail Biafra. Like I said, the truth cannot be oversized. Biafrans must open their eye, and every move they try and find out what is their mindset. What is the mindset behind everything they are doing? They have a plan. Yes, caller on the line. Caller on the line.
Good morning from here. Okay, this is your time to go to the calling from here.
Go ahead, please.
Yes, I want to thank you very much for your hard work and everything towards the restoration of our dear nation. I want to tell you, Chico Vicabia, and I thank you. Well, I want to show you that we love you. Love.
Go ahead.
I want to show you that we, the people of Biafra here in Aba, we are solidly behind you. And I want to show the Fulani people. We are also the people that that we are waiting for them. Any other one, we are waiting for them. We are just waiting for the help from our neighbor. So, Mark, I want to thank you. And I say, the people of Ghana will bless all of you from here and another. Thank you very much. God bless you. Right.
Thank you very much. We must continue. Caller on WhatsApp.
Yeah, good morning, Mazi.
Good morning from here. Go ahead, please.
Thank you, Mazi, for the opportunity you gave to me today. Mazi, I want to greet you for this message of him. I say, may Chukwu Okike bless you, bless your family, bless every IPOB that hear this word today. Mazi, I want to opportunity once again to may Chukwu Okike and bless our leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, the Ohamadike of Biafra land, the Onwa Onututu, Ebubedike, when Nebe and Asim Udonto Sepulo Wadderege, Drigin Mbedun, Drigin Utu, Drigin Efe, Drigin Abale, Drigin Eke, Drigin Oye, Drigin Afunkwo. Mazi, this topic today, honestly, is a very powerful. It's always a powerful all the days. Mazi Sanusi is a emir. They remove him. They are warming him up now for 2023. 2023 now, we'll see Sanusi come out for presidency in Nigeria.
And they have been able to catch our people, Mugu, some of our people. That is why we want them to wake up. They want to get your sympathy. They want to pretend as if they humiliate the man. And our people are very compassionate. If you do
very
not have it, they will keep. Before you know now, many IPOB members are going to be canvassing for Lamido Sanusi.
Lamido
have five names, different name. The name is answering today. It's not the name he answer as a governor of Central Bank. He's a terrorist. People don't know. Whatever they like, let them do. But our people should not allow them to deceive us. Sorry before you go ahead. My brother Chibuike Ogbonna on Facebook, what you said is correct. The person Facebook is using to fight me is in our platform. Believe me, I know the person, and I'm doing the needful. Mazi Chibuike, if you all notice now, at least for the past, let's say, 10 minutes, we notice my audio has increased because we are fighting them. Sometimes people come on air, Mazi, before we come on air, he say we are having technical issue. We know what we are going through here. So I want to tell you are right, and I know all of them. I'm following all of them. Don't worry, my brother. We will get there. If you observe my voice now, for the past 10 minutes, you will notice there is improvement. And that is because it can only get better. The thing they are doing, it will not pass this morning. For God is greater than all of them. And our cause is a just one. Sorry, my brother. Go ahead, please.
No problem. Sanusi is coming for 2023 presidential election. This is the plan. This Igbo people clamoring 2023, Igbo must take a presidency. Igbo this, Igbo that. But Igbo this. Honestly, walk this mass. Sanusi is an enemy of Kanu. He have a problem with it. I don't know how their culture about. Because of Sanusi see the television all the time criticizing over the poverty in the north. Now they take him out. And he have win some souls in the north. Which he will use for 2023 election. Mas, all these things is clamoring. Nigerian government, Nigerian politics, everything to humiliate Biafrans, but they will not. We have a one man. A man, it will die for his people. A man that already have sacrificed his parents, his mother, and his father. Is that person is a human being? No, it's not a human being. It's a dead man living. Nnamdi Kanu is a dead man living. And Radio Biafra is a place we learn everything we know in this life. I'm 40-something years today, but what I learned in Radio Biafra since I was born, I never heard it since I was born. But today, I can stand and bold and speak a word that you can hear and believe in me. Maza, I said, may God bless you. You are in Nigeria. Okay, we continue to guide you for us. Amen. Continue Amen. To bless Amen. You and your family. Nothing will harm you. Mazi, remain blessed Thank because you. The hand of God is taking you, sir.
Let's continue. Yes, this is Biafra land. My father, Mazi, land. Good morning, Ada.
I want to say I am hungry of Biafra. Because since that night when you baptized the whole president with their manufacturing sickness, since that night till now, I never hear of Radio Biafra. 102.1 in Akwa Ibom. I never received. Even my IPOB's brother for Aba Lagos called me. They asked me whether I hear the topic where our leaders brought out 3-4 days ago. But I tell them, say, my radio no work. But up here, we never hear anything about Biafra. I only target this line to call. I call female line in this switch off. I call WhatsApp in this switch off. No work. So I try the target Biafra time to get you, to tell you, see, since that time where you baptize them with this Toyota virus that night, till now, our radio work. I no hear you even this morning. I'm targeting you to get you.
So sorry for that, and your complaints are noted. I will make sure those who are handling that area will look into it.
Okay,
and it's
sir.
Good. It's good number you brought the message, the notification.
Okay,
go ahead.
Thank you. Number two is that again, time where you people open Shabbat for radio, many people were enjoying, and because of that, many people just, they worry me to connect them. I don't connect many people. I'm not tiring of connecting people to their friend movement. But now, I need to hear that Shabal again on radio. Why?
It depends on the presenter.
Yeah?
Depend on, or in fact, what happened is that they used to come on a presentation. But for some reason, that is not happening. But maybe in the nearest future they will still be coming up.
But are we not supposed to enjoy Shabbat on radio? Because other media they enjoy their radio.
But me, I'm not Shabbat now. and I cannot do it. You can tell you Barack Obama. It's not my. It's not. I don't know much about that, honestly.
Okay,
if I do, I can only teach in line of Christianity. But
okay,
the Jewish
sir.
Form, I don't know much about that, honestly.
Okay, sir.
But I want to be Thank that somebody you. Who worship on the Shabbat will prevent itself, make itself available to teach us on that. Because they can always come on air and teach us.
Okay, sir.
Thank you very much.
All right. Thank you.
We must continue. Biafrans across the globe must understand the reason why we do what we are doing is the same reason why your grandfather, your ancestors tell you story. They tell you story to help make use of your thinking faculty. We continually tell you what we're telling you. Sometimes we repeat our target is use your head. Use your head. Tomorrow now you wake up in the morning. They say vote for George Onyebe father for Nigerian president. Oh, we love George Onyebe. Vote for his father. It's a lie. It is the same music all over again. It is suffering begin. Your suffering continue. Vote article, vote. All of them are the same. Your suffering continue. The articulators say, you see, your suffering has started all over. It's even worse. We are talking of Oruja Sukura Osa. Now you have found Osa Mba of Osa, Osetiana. But of course, we will outlive all of them. And that is one truth all of us must embrace. Colin WhatsApp, are you there?
Good morning, yes. Master George Onyebe, good morning.
Good morning, my brother. Go ahead, please.
This is Chukwe Bukadi, calling from Aba.
As for the
full, these people have taken us for granted in this country. They have taken us for granted. As for the Sanusi, this is a broad criminal. You know, Fulani people, they used to think that we are known as we don't know anything. They use us as they want. But I'm sorry for some of our people who allow them to use them mysteriously. I'm very, very unhappy with our people. because anything concerning Fulani is fraud. The agenda is to wipe us. That is the agenda, which is very bad. Okay, look at a few days ago, how they thought our people in Okigwe. Honestly, as I saw that video, I was very shocked. In fact, I'm not happy. Even here in Aba, we are living, even such people, they are just my treaties anyhow. For granted, in our own father's land, it's very, very bad. Honestly,
it's very, very bad. Thank you very much. We must continue. Our people must understand the truth cannot be overemphasized. We want to go home. Ask yourself a question. What is the development Hausa, Fulani or Yoruba have done in Biafra land? They are the one ruling Nigeria. Only few Biafrans has ruled Nigeria. Please, what is investment? What is government in Biafra land? Okay, they give you stipends, militant money, and contract to guide the pipeline. My brothers, wake up. Wake up. Call on WhatsApp. Can you hear me?
Yes. Good morning, my rep. Good morning, Africa, Biafrans, lovers of freedom. My name is Joy. I'm calling from Ekom. My rep, I want to thank you for the job that you have been doing for this struggle, working tirelessly. I also want to thank our Onyendu, who have fulfilled the vow that he made, that he will sacrifice everything sacrificable. Today, our leader's presence is no more. He still continue. And our deputy, Mazu Chemefo, who has also that he will never allow this project to see corruption. Yes. And I want to thank all the principal officers for working assiduously in restoration of Biafra and all the Biafran along the globe. These people, they have come out today and they are telling us that Sanusi is no longer in the palace. And I begin to imagine the kind of escort that escorted this man off the palace yesterday, even if it happened to be an American president, a general. And you can't imagine the level of corruption that have eroded this country. If somebody who is an enemy will be equipped with that number of securities, everything, you will see that this country is finished. The country is finished because the evil that they are doing is beyond human understanding. And I want to assure every Afrans all over the world that we should remain formidable, that Biafra is here and nothing that we want but Biafra and Biafra. All hail Biafra.
All must hail Biafra. And I will draw the curtain for the segment. Like I said, we can only get Biafrans think. Anything you hear about radio on Radio Biafra, think about it because you never know. They can go ahead and be putting up game to deceive us, but don't allow yourself to be deceived. What we want, nothing more, nothing less. Do have a wonderful day as you go ahead your lawful and normal businesses across the globe, because I know Biafrans are good people, irrespective of anything, but we will get there. We will get home. Goodbye for now.
This song is dedicated to the victims of this genocide, those who lost their lives from 1997 to this very moment.
I had to do this song with Wee Woo, my brother man, I don't believe you. Shake a man, Kuru BTO, my brother man, listen up. Tell that Biafra soldier that he's gonna be alright. I need to tell that Biafra soldier. It's gonna be alright.
Sometimes